everybody. I thought today would be a good day just to chat with you and catch up with you. It is raining outside. It's like 30 some degrees. It's cold. Evan is at school. Henry's at school. Charlie, he's playing the tablet right now, his little iPad. So I thought this would be a perfect time to update you and just chat. So first of all, my hair, I've never in my life dyed it before until last night. Andy dyed my hair. And I know everybody tells me, everything I've read, anything anybody's told me is said, they have said, do not dye your hair by yourself the first time. But I did not want to spend the money to go to a salon. I didn't want like highlights or streaks. I didn't want anything, but it's just to look the same way it did, really, without gray in it. My hair has gotten super gray, and they're like not pretty grays. They're like all crinkly and not nice. And it was just getting to me, and I just was bothering me, and I thought, you know what, I'm just going to do it. Why not? I'm just going to do it. So I bought this yesterday, and Andy dyed my hair last night. I love him. I wish you guys knew him better. He's quiet, but he's such a great guy. And I also bought a 1-inch curler, and I watched tutorials trying to figure out how to like do my hair. I've been growing my hair out because I had such bad hair loss. I have a lot of loss back in here, and it's really, really thin. So I was growing it out so I could like cover it up, you know? But it just doesn't look good, and I'm trying to learn how to do it. So I bought the 1-inch curler, and I'm trying to learn how to curl it, and I've done it. I think this is okay. It's not terrible. I don't know, if I can't figure this out soon, I'm just gonna chop it. I think I'm gonna do like a bob again, and then maybe do like side swept. I've never had bangs in like since I was little, but I thought side swept bangs sort of like this would be cute. I don't know. Maybe I should just, I've always wanted to do a pixie, but I don't know, like longer on top and then short. So we'll see. But if I can't figure this out, chopping it is what I'm gonna do. Back up, I've had some health stuff going on. I was super weak. Just going up and down the stairs was hard. I couldn't do like basic, like making the beds, and I always had a bunch of joint pain. I had pain in like my right in here and my knees. So anyway, I've seen a lot of doctors and stuff, and I saw a rheumatologist, and she took like 8 vials of blood. I had a gazillion tests come back. The one thing that I learned was that I am severely anemic, and the ferritin is what helps absorb it. I think I'm saying that right. And that was basically non-existent. So that was the reason I was feeling so weak, and I just couldn't do the basic things. So I have been on iron pills for how long? Since Henry's birthday. So March, beginning of March about. And I'm feeling so much better, and the joint pain is actually gone. I'm feeling like almost 100%. It's pretty amazing. So that's how anemia can affect someone. It can make you just not be able to do anything. So I'm feeling super good. So anyway, so the rheumatologist, I went there because of the joint pain and stuff, and everything came back. All my tests came back, and I'm actually positive for something called P-ANCA, and it's MPO. It's like myelo. I don't know how to something. I can't pronounce it. And it's some sort of type of vasculitis. So she thought I have something brewing, but I'm not showing the symptoms because they went away. So that clearly was anemia symptoms before, the fatigue and all of that, since I'm better now. So that's good. Now I know I have some sort of next thing coming, some sort of autoimmune disease coming. And my mom has a really rare, like a serious form of vasculitis. So it's kind of good to know that I'm positive for a vasculitis. So the doctor said it's brewing, and it could be, you know, I could get it soon. It's something that I could get years from now. So it's just kind of nice to know, okay, keep my eyes open for any symptoms that I have. But as of now, I'm feeling awesome. I'm feeling so much better, and it just feels good to feel good, I guess. And my cough is unrelated, but I figured that out, and I have LPR, which is laryngopharyngeal reflux. So it is a silent reflux, and it's really tough because I don't know what affects it, but I figured out chocolate, peanut butter, pretty much anything I used to eat like daily. I used to eat peanut butter and apples every single day for lunch. Popcorn, I eat that for a snack every day. I can't eat that. And I love chocolate, and I've been avoiding that as well. Dairy affects me, tomatoes. So I know like the stuff that like completely takes my voice away. So now I just deal with a hoarse voice. I don't deal with no voice. It's either a good voice or maybe hoarse. So I'm glad I'm figuring that out. So that's that. So things are good with that. Charlie is doing really awesome. Potty training is going pretty well. It's not where it was, but we're getting there. Like, he's doing really, really well. I would say we have one accident a day, maybe, is all, if that. But I do ask a lot and kind of say you can get a candy if you go. I'm doing more of the, what do you call, proactive method, I guess. And yeah, he's doing awesome. Like, he just went by himself independently without me saying anything. So yeah, it's going really well. Another thing, so I've only ever done two sponsored videos, and it was for the same company, Home Chef, which we love the company. We really, really, really do. And they took my video without my permission and they uploaded it to Facebook. And so my video was, and they didn't link my channel. I didn't get any credit. No one would have known who I was or anything. And I saw my face on Facebook, and my aunt had called and saw it in Florida, called my dad, and everybody's seeing this video. And it took me a week to contact them to take it down. And then they didn't pay me to take my video and put it on all over Facebook as a sponsored post. So I was super disappointed. It's a bummer because I don't like people knowing that I have a YouTube channel. It just feels weird. I guess if they understood like the community and like the YouTube world and how it works. I've been sharing my life since 2008, and just look at all that you guys have seen, you know. I've gotten to share about type 1 diabetes and Charlie's heart defect. I've met so many people. I've gotten so many kind messages of people saying that I've helped them and that they learned from me. Even with my pregnancies and the kids having the choroid plexus cysts on their brain like they had, I've gotten so many, still to this day, messages about, thank you for explaining to us about what that is. You made us feel less nervous about it. And, you know, it's just such a neat world. This YouTube is such a cool world. And I'm just so happy to be part of it. But when family and friends know about it, I just hope they realize that this is a community that I have grown. And I'm proud of it. I really am proud of it. Like 18,000 of you. There's over 18,000 people have clicked the subscribe button, which is pretty awesome. My long-term goal forever since I started was 20,000, and I'm so close to my long-term goal. Like, I had not made a goal after that. 20,000 was like my ultimate goal. I never thought I'd get there, and I really think that it is possible. So it's pretty cool. YouTube is pretty awesome, and thanks to you guys. I mean, I wouldn't be here if you weren't here watching. So thank you for being here and supporting us and watching. And I think that all the time, and I'm so lucky to have you guys. Something very sad happened in my life. You guys know that I have friends from England, that family, that kid. They have come here 3 times. You guys have seen them on videos. The past 3, I've always shown videos of them since they first came here. My friend Andrea and her husband Matt, and they have 2 kids, Hannah and Fluffy. You guys remember them, I know you do. And nicest people you could ever meet in your life. They are the kindest, most caring, giving people I've ever met. Andy loves them. Our family just loves them. They are amazing people. She was diagnosed with breast cancer when her youngest son was just 5 months old. She had surgery and chemo, and I thought like she was getting better. Like, I thought she totally got over it the last time she was here, and I was just so happy that thinking, you know, she beat this. She beat this cancer. It came back and it got bad fast. It all happened super fast, and she passed away on Friday, which is so sad. If you know, her daughter has type 1 diabetes, same age as Henry. Her son is the same age as Charlie, he's 3. It's just a sad deal, so sad. It's such good people, you know, and they have diabetes going on. And then her mom developed breast cancer, and she had surgery. So that family has been through so much. I took a picture to send to Andy today, and it's just hard when I see Andrea's thing come up to like send to her. You know how like it shows what you typically go to, you know, your buttons, like when you use your camera, and her little Facebook messaging was right there. It's like, oh my gosh, I totally would have sent her a picture showing her my newly dyed hair if I could have. So yeah, it's just so sad, and it's heartbreaking. I ended on a sad note. I'm sorry, guys. Thank you for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. If you like chatty vlogs, give me a thumbs up. It helps me out. Trying to get to that 20,000 goal. I think I can do it. All right. Talk to you later, guys. Bye.